else remembers David Erez? Back in November, he was sitting in the stands with his wife at the Scotiabank Arena, and the Hurricanes goalie, James Reimer, went down with an injury. Now, David, if you remember this story, was the Zamboni driver, and he was also the emergency netminder for that day's game. So he left his wife in the stands and put on his gear, just in the off chance that something might also happen to the Carolina backup goalie. Partway through the second period, David's called up to the ice. Can you imagine? At this point, by his own account, David's scared stiff, and he allows the first two goals passed before blocking the next eight in what became a stunning victory for the Hurricanes against the Leafs. It was in large part thanks to a Zamboni driver who started the game as a spectator and became a participant. It's not unlike another David that we read about in the Bible who shows up with food for his brothers who are facing off with Goliath, and he ends up becoming an unexpected hero. He started the day as a spectator, and when the opportunity came, he stepped up as a participant. It can work both ways, though. Consider just recently rookie quarterback Washington Redskins Dwayne Haskins. His teammate, who was a cornerback, had just caught an interception in the final seconds of the game, and the crowd is going wild in what seems to be a certain 19-16 win for the Redskins, which was going to be their first home win of the season. Dwayne was so caught up in the enthusiasm of the crowd that rather than participating in the final snap of the game with his team, he was in the crowd taking selfies with fans. There's a big difference between being a spectator and being a participant. It's the difference between watching everything unfold and actually being a part of the action. Go ahead and turn with me to 1 Peter chapter 4. We're going to read verses 7 through 11. The end of the world is coming soon. Therefore, be earnest and disciplined in your prayers. Most important of all, continue to show deep love for each other, for love covers a multitude of sins. Cheerfully share your home with those who need a meal or a place to stay. God has given each of you a gift from His great variety of spiritual gifts. Use them well to serve one another. Do you have the gift of speaking? Then speak as though God Himself were speaking through you. Do you have the gift of helping others? Do it with all the strength and all the energy that God supplies. Then everything you do will bring glory to God through Jesus Christ. All glory and power to Him forever and ever. Amen. Notice here what Peter doesn't say. He doesn't describe a position in the stands. He doesn't give us the spiritual equivalent of bench warming. He doesn't say, those of you who the Spirit has not given gifts. Instead, he says that each of us has been given gifts. He gives us a picture in which everyone participates together, like a family or a body. It can be easy to think of church as being a place where we go for a weekly pick-me-up, a club where we meet with other friends and we're served together, a place where we can be entertained, like a concert or a TED Talk or a pep rally. Now, certainly, we can be served in these ways as a part of the church body. Just like being on a team can be entertaining, and it certainly is encouraging. But if you come expecting to stay a spectator at church or on a team, you're going to be disappointed, and your team is also going to be disappointed. Now, when the Zamboni driver stepped onto the ice, he said that he was overwhelmed, that the transition from spectator to participant isn't always easy. But if he hadn't made that transition successfully to being a member of the team, we wouldn't know his name today. The Leafs might have appreciated not being known as the team that lost to a Zamboni driver, though. There aren't any spectator positions in a church, because the true church is made up of individuals who are following Jesus. Jesus, who has brought us together to serve as one so that the good news of what Jesus has done can be shared. We call that evangelism. So that those who want to count the cost or who have already counted the cost of following Jesus can learn how to follow Jesus better. We call that discipleship. If you're a follower of Jesus, you have purpose. You are an important and integral part of the body that Jesus has called to be the church. And yes, even to be this church. In John 17, Jesus does describe church spectators, those on the outside looking in. And once we've decided to follow Jesus, there's no dugout to hide in. We're called to participate in the community in such a way that the world will know that we have God's love and that we share God's love with one another. There are no spectators in a body, but there are a lot of people who are looking on in our community, in our families, among our friends, people who are watching us to find out, whether they know it or not, to find out what makes following Jesus different from the way that they're doing life. They might be cheering us on, they might be jeering as we draw closer to the purpose that we've been called to by Jesus, as we practice those gifts that we've been given by the Holy Spirit. But they are watching. And we aren't just spectators once we've decided to follow Jesus. Now, I want to encourage you to be a participant by joining in the discussion. If you're able to make it to our 6:30 service, we meet every 6:30 at Ken Cooley Park. Otherwise, you can certainly join us online too. There's a link below to our website, gracepoint.ca, where you can find our electronic bulletin with a discussion guide. And I'd love to engage with you either in the comments for the video here or via email. And you can reach me at weston@gracepoint.ca. Thank you for your time today. Thank you for considering what it means to be a part of the body of the church. God bless.